number of wins and victories and championship fights, title defenses. You know what? It was a very good fight. You know, if they have another option, maybe they do that first. Maybe the money wasn't right. I don't know. That's a lot of
money. That's what he said.
It takes a lot to get a fight done. Not everybody gets a rematch done like Santa Cruz Frampton right, you know, off the back like that. Yeah. It takes a lot, but it might not have been worth it for him.
Oh, that fight and he turns out right. A lot of people, they kind of shocked at that.
You know, it was a very good fight. I think it was a close fight. I think they do need to have a rematch to kind of settle the dispute there, because it was very close. Could that mean the way?
Far from a robbery, though.
Yeah, it wasn't a robbery. Some people claim robbery. I didn't see that. But they should have a rematch. It may not be next five or two fights, but they should have a rematch.
It's a crazy tournament, you're aware.
If he decides to retire, that's maybe up to him. I doubt that he'd be retired now. He's at the top of the game right now.
And he was sitting out for so long as well. He had issues problems with his promoter. He was sitting out. He comes back and does a couple of fights.
Doesn't sound right. Doesn't make sense. Business or for legacy. Or, no way.
Robert said it was almost like when Chino McDonald. He left so many behind, so many big fights, so much money.
I don't think he's at that position. See, Maidana didn't even want to fight anymore when he came to my brother's gym. He was ready to retire. And they re-energized him, and they had the best part of his career. But he was ready to retire. So it was extra. He didn't care for it so much. Anything else, he was happy with what he had.
He made a lot of money in the Mayweather price. He made like a king, you know. Just,
of course. You know, he made so much money. He made the most amount of money when he was ready to retire.
Yeah.
You know? So his mind is a little different than the war. I don't think he's on his retire for now. It'd be, you know, a shame and sad to see him retire. That's it, he's at the top of the game.
Mikey, in the sense of they say that this was the best fight, you know what I mean? Everybody knew that this was the best fight. And in the sense of that was the best fight for him as far as competition, and it doesn't do the pay-per-view buys that he would expect it to do. In that sense, does he think like, well, then what's next? Who gets better? Who makes it better for him? Can you touch on that?
They don't do the buys that they expected or that they would hope for.
When they're saying that is the match.
That was the fight, yes. But okay, look at Crawford and Rosol.
Yeah.
For the 140 division, that was the fight. And I heard it was
50,000 pounds.
Bad numbers. So I don't know who to blame. I don't know if it's the fighters or promoters, marketing, media. I don't know. That's not my business. But you know, sometimes the great fights like that are evenly matched and both at the time don't generate the response that people expect. And then there are other guys who are just, they have a following and they're fan friendly and they do great numbers. Maybe not the greatest fighters, but they do great shows. They put on a great show. You just never know. It's a risk. Going on pay-per-view is a risk for more than the fighters. Their stock probably went down a little bit because they couldn't get those numbers. Crawford was told couldn't get those numbers that they wanted. Maybe their next few fights are not going to be as great pages, but they just weren't there. It's business, politics, business, promoters, managers.
At this point, you're